Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is as requested by some of you. I'm doing this introductory video on how to study for the A-level exams, and those are the students who are joining A-levels in the August of 2022. I'm just giving them a guide how to study and how to be really formulating a policy or a timetable in which you will be able to achieve one of your best grades. The first thing to download and have with you in as a hard copy, I always say keep a hard copy. That's important. You have it in your phones and in your iPads and laptops, but still a hard copy is a better idea. Is the syllabus for, as you can see here, the syllabus has been amended for 2022, 2023 and 2024. Now, if you are starting your A-level classes in August 2022, well, you're going to take the exam in 2024. So this syllabus has been written for the class of 2024, and if you're taking, even if you're taking the AS level in 2023, this syllabus is valid for you all. So this is the syllabus which you need to have and which you need to print out and keep a copy of it with you at all times. Now, looking at the number of papers you have a paper 1, which is an MCQ paper, and the timing has been increased to 1 hour 15 minutes, and this is the paper which usually is at the end of the exam, and this is now, as this year it's in the beginning of June, on the 9th of June. Paper 2 is, you can see, as this is for 1 hour and 15 minutes, and it is going to be a 40 marks, and it's an MCQ, and the paper 2 is also 1 hour 15 minutes. But this has structured questions on it, and this is for 60 marks, but this is also for 1 hour and 15 minutes. And these are questions which are based on the AS level syllabus, and this is also on the AS level syllabus. So if you are going to take the AS exam, you have to take a paper 1, a paper 2, and a paper 3. Now, the paper 3 is a component which you have to take in the AS level. So AS level means you have to take paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3. If you want to do it, you'll be doing it in 2023, and some schools do it, some schools don't do it, so it's up to where you enter, which school you go to. So this is a practical work, and this is going to be 2 hours, and this is going to be lab work, and you'll be examined in the lab. And in the last 2 years, we've had Cambridge allowing us an exemption, and some students do not take this paper 3. But I'm not sure if for June 2023 this exemption will be allowed or not. We have yet to get information from Cambridge about that. So if you're taking the AS level, you will take the paper 1, which is 40 marks. You will take the paper 2, which is again 60 marks at the same time. So this is 40 marks, this is 60 marks, and as you can see here, this practical is also for 40 marks. So if you take the paper 3, if you take the paper 3, that is also for 40 marks. Now, this paper 3, so that means you will be taking 3 exams if you take these, and these will be at the in June 2023 if you take the AS. But if you take the composite means you take all the 5 papers in one go, and that will be in 2024. I, of course, always advise you to do that. I myself advocate the composite. I do not advocate the AS level, but it's up to you all. I'm not thrusting my opinions on you. Now, coming to the A2 syllabus. Now, the A2 syllabus is going to be just paper 4 and paper 5. So A2 syllabus will only be paper 4 and paper 5. And A2, the paper 4 is, of course, very, very difficult. It's for 100 marks, and it is for 2 hours. And it's a very challenging paper, and you must be very well prepared for it. Paper 5 is again planning, analysis and evaluation. So this is another very difficult paper. This is for 30 marks, and this is for 1 hour and 15 minutes. This is for 2 hours, and this is for 100 marks. And this is for 30 marks in one. And paper 2 and paper 5 is on the same day. So if you're taking the composite exam, then the paper 2 and the paper 5 will be on the same day. But if for instance student A has taken in 2023 paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3, and paper 3 as well, well, okay, then that's out of the way. He will then only take in 2024, he will only take paper 4 and paper 5. But if a student who's taking the exam in 2024 takes all the five papers, then the paper two and the paper five are both on the same day. They're always tabled on the same day. So you have to take the paper two, then you have a 10-minute break, and then you do the paper five. Now that's the rule which Cambridge follows. So this is the paper. This is the marks for the papers. The fact that you all must know there are five papers you've got to take. The first three are on the AS level syllabus. Now let's go across through the syllabus. Now, if you look at the syllabus, this is the AS level syllabus. AS level has 11 chapters. Cell structure, biological molecules, enzymes, cell membrane and transport, the mitotic cell cycle, nucleic acid and protein synthesis, transport in plants, transport in mammals, a gas exchange, infectious disease and immunity. Now, this is all very much like the O levels, and most of the topics are the same as the O levels. But of course, they are much more complex and they are much more advanced and there are much more details that we need to know now. So these will be examined in the paper one, which is the MCQ paper, in the paper two, which is the short answer question, and the paper three, which is going to be the practical. So these are three are going to be the one which are going to be on these 11 chapters. Now, whether you take it after 1 year or whether you take it after 2 years, it's immaterial, but it'll be the same paper which you will be taking as well as the students who are taking the composite, which means the five papers. It will be the same paper which they will go through. Now, 11 chapters here in AS syllabus. Now, usually schools will finish this in the first 4 or 5 months, and by January, I usually finish them by February because we start with you in the end of August, so we only have September, October, November, December. And by January, we've usually finished. I have usually finished it, but some students or some teachers, of course, go on to February or even March. Then we have, this will be, of course, the AS level. These are 11 chapters. And the A2 level has only 8 chapters. So these 8 chapters are, of course, very, very difficult. You might say, oh my God, only 8 chapters. But no, they're very, very complex and they're very. There are a lot of details which we need to learn and memorize and understand. So it's respiration, photosynthesis, homeostasis, control and coordination, inheritance, selection and evolution, classification, biodiversity and conservation, and genetic technology. Plus, you have to know the practical skills as well because the paper five, which is sort of not an alternative to practical, but it examines your practical skills and analytical skills, and even you have to plan an experiment. So this would be the 8 chapters. So these are the 8 chapters which you need to know for your A2 syllabus. So A2 syllabus is you might think, oh my God, less number of chapters, but of course this is much more details and we need quite a lot of time to teach you this as well. Now we're just going through the first chapter to give you a little feel of the A levels. And this is this chapter one, which is the cell structure, which is the basic which we do in O levels as well. The microscope in cell studies and the learning outcomes. Candidate should be able to make temporary preparations of cellular material suitable for viewing with a light microscope. Draw cells from microscope slides and photomicrographs. Calculate magnifications of images and actual sizes of specimens from drawing, photomicrographs, and electron micrographs, scanning and transmission. Use an eyepiece, graticule, and stage micrometer to make measurements to use the appropriate units, millimeters, micrometers, and nanometers. Define resolution and magnification and explain the difference between these terms with reference to light microscopy and electron microscopy. So when you look at the syllabus, and if you've gone through the syllabus point-wise, there is no way that you are then going to struggle with answering the questions, because whenever the paper is made, it would be then specified that it is made on 1.1 part 3 of the syllabus. So any question made has to address the syllabus. If you have studied point-wise from the syllabus, I am 100% that you can do any question on any of the papers. So this is a very good outline for you, a very guideline for you to really study for the A levels. If you follow the syllabus, life is going to be easy for you. Now, the Cambridge International ASN A-Level Biology 9700 is the published resource is this book. Now, this book is a good book. I mean, I've been asking students to buy it. We've had students taking the exam this year. They like it, they do not like it, they have their own choices. Some of you like to study from notes, some of you like to study from YouTube, some of you like to make your own notes, and some of you just like to take notes from the teacher. If you are very confident and you are very happy with the teacher, then you like the notes that she gives you in the class and he or she gives you in the class. So it's up to you to buy this book or to have an e-book and have it in your phones and in your laptops and iPads. So I'm not saying that you need to buy the book. I'm not even telling you not to buy the book, but it's up to you how every child has their own method of studying. Every child has his own method of making their notes or studying in their own manner. So, but this is the standard book which has been asked by Cambridge that we should have it. Of course, it has the entire syllabus in it. And this has the revised syllabus, which is because you see the syllabus changed in 2022. So if you use an older version, then it won't have the new content. There is an older version of it. So, but I would not advise you to buy the older version. I would like you to use this new version, which is, of course, the one which has been updated for the new syllabus. Now, basic study technique and timetable which you must follow in the A levels is that you revise every day. Whatever you've done in the school, if you've had a bio class in school, then you must revise every day. Whatever you did in school, you must go home and revise it. Even if it takes you just half an hour or 15 minutes, just revise it. Now, when you complete the chapter, when the teacher has completed the chapter, then you attempt the questions on it. You see, you must not leave it to a later date. You must attempt the questions on this chapter from a topic-wise past paper booklet. You know, you get these past paper booklets. If you're doing an AS level chapter, like you've done the first chapter on the AS level, you've done the cell structure chapter, and the teacher has finished it for you, then you must do the questions on that chapter from paper 1 and paper 2. Because you see, this chapter is going to be examined in paper 1 and paper 2. So you must do the MCQs on that chapter, and you must do the topic, the paper 2, which is the short answer questions. Then you must do those from the paper 2 as well, so that you know what type of MCQs are going to come on it and what type of paper 2 questions are going to come on it. Similarly, when you enter the A2 class, which will be in 2023, then in the A2 you must finish the chapter. As soon as the teacher finishes the chapter, you must start doing the questions on that chapter from paper 4 and paper 5. Because if there is a chapter like respiration is in A2 syllabus, then questions can come in the paper 4 and in the paper 5 on that. So you must have a topical in which you do topic-wise, as soon as you finish a chapter, at least do a large number of questions on that chapter. And that gives you a very good understanding what sort of question can come in the exam. And that is that student who does that, I'm sure, just breezes through the exams and finds the exams very, very easy. Of course, I'm not saying A levels is easy. A levels is very difficult, and you have to start from day one. You can't do it like you do it in O levels. In O levels, even if you study in the last 2 months, you can get a grade. But in the A levels, I'm sorry, you can't get a grade even if you study for the last 3 months. You have to start from day one. You have to really be ahead of the class. You have to be ahead of the teacher. As soon as he or she finishes a chapter, you should have done all the questions on it so that whenever a test is done, you do well in the test. And it is very important that you, in the first year, the 11 chapters of the AS Biology, you must be very well versed in it, because as soon as the school opens for the second year, which is the A2, then things become very difficult, because the A2 syllabus is even more difficult than the AS syllabus. I'm not trying to scare you, but I'm telling you that you need to be very focused, and you need to be very clear-headed when you're taking A-level biology. Sciences are very, very tough. All the three sciences are very tough, and you need to be very regular in your studies. The resources available to you are books, notes. These are all available online, and you can, I'm sure, look through. There's some sort of different types of notes which are available to you on different sites for A level. And now, as with the corona and the COVID-19, we've had a lot of resources added to the internet. So you have a lot of resources available. You have the YouTube lectures which you can access to. There are many teachers who have put up YouTube lectures. You have some paid, some websites, you have some which are unpaid, and then you can access that. But the basic thing is what you've got to understand, it is you that needs to study. All these YouTube lectures and everything are available to all the students, but some will of course access them, some will get a lot of help from them, but others choose not to take any help from them and then, you know, just struggle and just involve themselves in a blame game, blame the school, blame the teachers, blame the books, blame anything on this earth but except blame themselves. So I think you all need to realize is that now you are in the driving seat and you need to decide how much time do you want to give to your A-level studies, how much time do you want to give to Netflix, how much time do you want to give to video games. That is for you to decide. So please understand is that it is your decision to take A-level biology and you must be very okay with that. You must be okay with the intensive study hours that you'll need to put in if you have to really get a good score. Of course, if you were just aiming for a C or a D, then of course you need to put in minimal effort and you probably would get a C or a D, but that is also very difficult in A-levels. So all the best and thank you very much. And please do let me know if there's anything else which I can help you with the class which takes the exam in 2024. And all the very best. And thank you for subscribing and thank you for watching my YouTube lectures. Thank you.